engaged in some interference or obstruction of the investigation. I think we know enough now. There's been enough alleged publicly to want to bring the director back to testify, ideally in open session, either before our committee or the Judiciary Committee, but he should come back to the Congress and share what he knows in terms of the President's conversations with him on any of the Russia investigation. I also think that we ought to ask for the notes that were taken contemporaneously or shortly after those meetings. And of course, if there are any tapes, as the President alleged, those should also be obtained by the Congress. If necessary, I think we should subpoena them, but hopefully we can obtain any of these materials voluntarily. But on the heels of an allegation that the President himself acknowledged that he brought up in the context of whether the director would stay on as director, whether he was a subject of investigation, in the context of reports by the director or associates of the director that he was asked essentially for a loyalty test to the President, and now with allegations that the President urged him to essentially drop the investigation of Michael Flynn, enough is enough. Congress really needs to get to the bottom of this. We did have an opportunity to inquire further about the reports of a discussion within the White House with the Russian Foreign Minister and Russian Ambassador. I don't have much I can share in terms of our discussions on that. I can only say that I remain concerned about allegations that the President shared information with the Russians that was not vetted in advance by our intelligence agencies. It's one thing to do this as a product of interagency thought and deliberation about information that needs to be shared. It's another thing to do it spontaneously, impetuously, or in a way that might endanger sources of information. So I think there's still more for us to learn in terms of whether classified information was shared with the Russians. That was an answer that General McMaster was not willing to give today, and also whether any mitigation steps need to be put in place.